cellphone circuit board, gold recovery. So, next with a low grade cellphone circuit board, and we don't use nitric acid. So, what's the process? This is total of 1.1 kilogram. I accumulate a couple months ago. So, let's begin. Okay, this is our steps to recover our cell phone circuit board. Step 1, gold extraction using copper chloride, old acid peroxide solution. Step 2, dissolving gold foils using acid peroxide, which is hydrochloric acid and 6% hydrogen peroxide by heating this solution. Step 3, gold precipitation using sulfurization process by adding sodium metabisulfite. So let's proceed. So let's add our cell phone circuit board to our large speaker, just like that. Our material here is successfully added to our beaker. So what I have prepared here is hydrochloric acid with dissolved copper. This is my old EP solution in my previous video that I use, and this is also active. We will check this one every day. We only check this one every day, or morning, afternoon, or evening. And today, April 25, 2023, and after 7 hours, as you can see, from 1400 hours to 2100 hours, I see that there is so many gold foil is extracted, and I believe this copper chloride is very good to extract gold from cell phone circuit board. This is highly recommended old EP solution. Very nice reaction, as you can see. So I will check it tomorrow if I extract all the gold from circuit board, so that we can continue our process very fast. And today is April 26, 2023, and let's see what happened to our job here. As you can see, blurry. Lots of gold foils extracted from our material here. I believe that this process is very good, as you can see, in just a more than 24 hours. The gold foil extracted has increased, so I decided to add a little bit of fresh hydrochloric acid. And today, April 28, 2023, after 3 days, I found that I extract too many gold foil here. So let's slowly filter the solution. Lots of floating gold foil here. So let's begin filtering to my large filter paper. Our filtration is running too slow. I don't have any option here, because if we find another ways like filtered cotton, so I found that after a few hours I see that some gold foil has passing through the filtered cotton also, and very tiny particle. So to prevent that, we use filter paper for filtration and capture the gold. So prevent adding water here, because it's making you trouble, and because copper chloride and forming copper too if you add this solution with water. As long as our filtration has running very slow, and we patiently wait the process is over. After a couple hours of filtering, and this is our gold foil capture in our filter paper, but for now it's not recognized as gold foil because of and maybe tin. So let's clean up this one. Our first steps, gold extraction using our copper chloride solution, is now completed, and let's proceed to the next steps. Drying our gold foil to react the acid faster. So what I had prepared here is hydrochloric acid, 35%, 100 ml, and hydrogen peroxide, that is 20 volumes, that is 6%. We prepare here maybe 20 ml. Hydrogen peroxide. So let's pour our 100 ml hydrochloric acid to our gold foil. Then heat a little bit. That is our gold foil, very nice color. And cover. And I think that's enough heating. We boil our hydrochloric acid. Now let's add our 20 ml hydrogen peroxide here. The solution is slowly turning yellow. And after 15 minutes of boiling with hydrogen peroxide, and I think I dissolve all the gold foil here. White fumes, not red fumes. So let's allow it to cool down and filter. Now it's time to filter our solution here. Our prepared plastic bucket to capture solids. Now I'm done filtering, and I had captured a sticky. We will run this one to our filter paper here. Almost clean solution. And that is exactly look like our solution here, very clear and no colloidal solids. So let's precipitate the gold using sulfurization. This is the last steps of our process. We precipitate gold using sodium metabisulfite here, food grade. So let's take a look what happened here. If we got gold or not. Boom. Okay. That's enough precipitation. So let's allow to settle down and let's see tomorrow. Add water here to reduce the acidity. The solution turning into black color. After more than 24 hours, because I left this job, I have a work, and this is our solution. And that is our black precipitation here. See that? What we are going to do now is to clean up and boiling with water in hydrochloric treatment, then melt. Okay, decantation. Okay, transfer to a smaller beaker for easy washing. Add distilled water. Do not use tap water. Distilled water is chlorine free. Okay, boiling of distilled water just like that. Boiling at least 8-10 minutes. Then repeat this process at least 3 times until the water is clean. Allowing to cool down and settle down our gold here. See that? After 3 times boiling with water and 3 times hydrochloric treatment, that is our gold. Now catching our gold to our filter paper here. After catching the gold into our filter paper, then we add a small amount of carbonate here to hold the gold very tight. And fire to our mop gas. Okay, that's baby. Very small button. We don't expect too much of our material because that is mixed with low grade. Very shiny. So let's take to our scale. Turn on. Very small button, but very shine. Yeah, some sodium carbonate here at the back, but it's not so complicated. Boom, 0.63. So thank you so much for watching, and God bless you, everyone.